a return address in the Netherlands, in Europe, not in China. So here's the thing, the packets appear to be Chinese, but there's no concrete proof of their source, not yet.
Buried in the findings are reports that at least one person discovered lots of small centipedes in the soil surrounding the plants. And in another case, an inspector noted seeds were not basil, it is poison ivy and native to Australia and is invasive. Invasive species are a serious problem.
Because weeds are competing for the same resources as our crop plants, for light and nutrients and moisture, of course, and they're quite limited, especially in our prairie agricultural system, so we have to be careful of that.
The seeds appear to be part of a brushing scam where online retailers send out small freebies, then post positive reviews of themselves. The Better Business Bureau says there could still be a big cost down the line.
One, it means that somebody else has your data, so they can be using your username, your password, whatever you might have stored in there. As well, they might have your credit card information.
After receiving the seeds, Crystal Smalden faced that very problem.
My work credit card was compromised a period of time after that, and they couldn't trace to where.
The BBB says if you're caught in a brushing scam, change your passwords and monitor your accounts. The CFIA says if you receive any unknown plant material, including seeds, call their offices to report it, but definitely don't plant it. Kevin Green, CTV News, Calgary.
We've got a lot more information on this story, including links to the CFIA site for reporting mystery seeds and plants on our website at ctvnewscalgary.ca.
Well, we all buried in the findings are reports that at least one person discovered lots of small centipedes in the soil surrounding the plants. And in another case, an inspector noted seeds were not basil, it is poison ivy and native to Australia and is invasive. Invasive species are a serious problem.
Because weeds are competing for the same resources as our crop plants, for light and nutrients and moisture, of course, and they're quite limited, especially in our prairie agricultural system, so we have to be careful of that.
The seeds appear to be part of a brushing scam where online retailers send out small freebies, then post positive reviews of themselves. The Better Business Bureau says there could still be a big cost down the line.
One, it means that somebody else has your data, so they can be using your username, your password, whatever you might have stored in there. As well, they might have your credit card information.
After receiving the seeds, Crystal Smalden faced that very problem.
My work credit card was compromised a period of time after that, and they couldn't trace to where.
The BBB says if you're caught in a brushing scam, change your passwords and monitor your accounts. The CFIA says if you receive any unknown plant material, including seeds, call their offices to report it, but definitely don't plant it. Kevin Green, CTV News, Calgary.
We've got a lot more information on this story, including links to the CFIA site for reporting mystery seeds and plants on our website at ctvnewscalgary.ca.
Well, we all a return address in the Netherlands, in Europe, not in China. So here's the thing, the packets appear to be Chinese, but there's no concrete proof of their source, not yet. Last Ireland, a woman has reported receiving seeds as early as June. She says the envelope she received was marked with Chinese characters, just like the American ones, but it had a return address in the Netherlands, in Europe, not in China. So here's the thing, the packets appear to be Chinese, but there's no concrete proof of their source, not yet. There are only accounts of people who've received them and warnings from the authorities. The authorities investigating the matter are yet to establish a direct link to China. That's something they suspect.
Packets of seeds that started appearing on doorsteps across Canada last year, the Canadian Food Inspection Agency scrambled to round them up and destroy them.
Right, but CTV News has learned in a lot of cases Canadians actually planted the seeds, and sometimes what grew was potentially dangerous. Kevin Green reports.
Crystal Smalden got a package of seeds in the mail last year. She hadn't ordered them. She sent the seeds to the Canadian Food Inspection Agency.
I sent it over to them, but I've never heard anything.
Smalden wasn't alone. Documents obtained by CTV show hundreds of Canadians received mystery seeds, mostly from China, mainly delivered through retailers Amazon and Wish. CFIA investigators collected the seeds and destroyed them, but not before several dozen Canadians actually planted them. These pictures of the growing plants are from hundreds of documents received through an access to information request.